Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to share some hairstyles using Dutch fishtail braids. I don't think I've done a combination video with this type of braid before, so let me know in the comments section which of the three hairstyles is your favorite. Also, make sure to like and subscribe if you're new to my channel, then you'll never miss any future videos, and let's get started. For the first style, I want my braid to go down the left side of my head, so I'm going to have my hair parted in a deep side part, so I'm going to have my part on the right side, just so I can utilize as much hair as possible. And I'm going to begin by separating out a few pieces from along the hairline to frame my face once the style is done. So then I'm going to pick up a piece near the part line and divide this into three smaller pieces. I like to start these braids like a regular three-strand braid. So I'm crossing the two side strands under the middle strand one time for the initial stitch. Then I'm going to combine two of the sections together and switch the braid to a fishtail style braid. So for the fishtail braid, I'm going to be dividing off small sections of hair from one side and then cross them underneath to the opposite side and add them into the hair that I'm holding in my hand. And as I braid, I also want to bring in the hair from my head. So I'm going to cross a small section underneath to the opposite side and then divide off a small section of hair from my head and cross it underneath to the opposite side as well. I'm going to be doing this on both sides of the braid. So I'm alternating between crossing a small section from the left side under to the right side, picking up a new section of hair from my head, and crossing it under to the right side as well. And then I'm going to switch and cross a small piece from the right side under to the left, then divide off a small section of hair from along my head and cross it underneath to the left side as well. So for this particular hairstyle, I'm going to form the braid down the left side of my head so it drapes over my shoulder. So I'm going to make sure to bring in the hair from the hairline and down from the part line. And as I bring in the hair, I'm going to start sweeping the hair from the right side of my head so it drapes around the back of my head and goes into the braid instead of crossing over the top of my head. This will give the hairstyle a softer look. So I'm alternating between crossing a small section from the left side under to the right side, picking up a new section of hair from my head, and crossing it under to the right side as well. And then I'm going to switch and cross a small piece from the right side under to the left, then divide off a small section of hair from along my head and cross it underneath to the left side as well. So I'm just going to continue dividing off small sections of hair from one side, crossing them under to the opposite side, and then picking up new sections of hair from along my head and bringing them into the braid as well. Then once I've brought in all of the hair from my head, I'm going to continue braiding the section down the length of hair until it reaches near the bottom. Now I want my braid to be really big and full, so I'm going to go back over the sides and pull on the edges so they carefully slide out of the braid. This will give the overall hairstyle a more casual and lived-in look. You can really make this braid as big as you'd like, and a texturizing powder or dry shampoo can really give the hair some grit so it'll pull out more easily without falling loose. Then so the braid doesn't unravel, I'm just going to tie off the bottom using a clear elastic band and then set the style with a medium hold hairspray just to help smooth down any flyaways and help keep the style in place. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to place my braid on the left side of my head again so my hair is parted on the right side. Then I'm going to divide off some hair to frame my face and then pick up a section for my braid. This is going to be right near the part line at the top of my head. And I'm creating the same type of fishtail braid. So after the initial stitch of the braid, I'm going to combine two of the sections together so I have two strands for the fishtail braid. And I'm going to begin dividing off a small section of hair from one side and cross it underneath to the opposite side that I'm holding in my hands. And with each cross under, I'm also going to be incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. And I want to create the braid along the left side of my head, slightly angled towards the back of my head, since I'm going to be placing my hair into a ponytail. So I'm just going to continue dividing off small sections of hair from one side, crossing them under to the opposite side, and then picking up new sections of hair from along my head and bringing them into the braid as well. And once the braid trails above my left ear, and I've brought in all of the hair from the left side of my head, and the braid reaches just behind my ear, I'm going to stop adding in new sections and just continue braiding the section down the length of hair until it reaches near the bottom. And then I'm going to take a clip and place this over the end of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to combine the remaining hair together, adding in the braid last, and tie all of it off using a hairband. And then once the hair is tied off, I'm going to go back over the braid and pinch and pull on the edges so it slides out just slightly, making the braid wider and more full. Then to finish off the hairstyle, I'm going to divide off a small section of hair from out of the ponytail and wrap this around the hairband a few times. And then I'm just going to take a bobby pin and pin down the wrapped section underneath the ponytail using a bobby pin. Working off of the last hairstyle, instead of finishing the hairstyle in a ponytail, I'm going to create a low messy bun. So with all of the hair combined together with the braid at the nape of my neck, I'm going to wrap the hair with a hairband. And on the second wrap of the hairband, I'm going to pull the hair partway through so it creates a loop with the hair at the nape of my neck. And now with the ends sticking out from the bottom of the bun, I'm going to divide this into two sections, and I'm going to wrap each one around the top of the bun in opposite directions. So one half is going up the left side and the other half is going up the right side, crossing them over the top of the bun. And then I'm going to bring them back down underneath the bun and tuck the ends around the hairband so they stay in place. And then I'm just going to loosen the hair around the crown of my head to add a little bit of texture to the hairstyle. And I'm going to pull on small sections of the bun so it's a little messier. And this will just help create a softer, more lived-in hairstyle.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Be sure to let me know in the comment section which of the three hairstyles was your favorite. And if you haven't subscribed already, make sure to subscribe and click that notification bell so you never miss any future videos. And I will see you next time.